stonewalling. How to stop stonewalling, aka the silent treatment. If you've experienced the silent treatment and you want to put an end to somebody who's stonewalling you, then stay tuned. This lesson is for you. What's up, X-Learners? MD here, helping you upgrade your life through better communication. Be sure to subscribe to join our tribe of X-Learners and get all the videos helping you become a better communicator. So first of all, let's define stonewalling. Stonewalling is when somebody stops talking to you. That's why we call it the silent treatment, because they're not saying anything to you. But little do they know that in the absence of words, in the absence of verbal communication, they're actually communicating something to you through their silence, right? You can tell when a person is angry, upset, frustrated, when they just shut down and they don't want to talk and they just can't find the words to express themselves. But in this video, I'm going to teach you what to do, what to say, more explicitly, to somebody who is stonewalling you so that you can actually help, one, figure out what's going on, and two, be able to problem solve and come to a solution. And that is what we want, X-Learners. Generally speaking, people tend to stonewall when they have an issue with something or someone, and they're not able to express these frustrations or feelings of anger or the reason they're upset to begin with. We've all experienced the silent treatment. But here's the thing. If you can't verbalize your frustrations, your emotions, your feelings, what's going on, what's ailing you, then it's going to make it 100 times harder to actually resolve the problem. You will arrive much sooner at a solution if you're able to express what is going on and what's bothering you. So that is why stonewalling and giving somebody the silent treatment is so detrimental and doesn't help at all with repairing relationships or figuring out the problem and trying to come at a resolution. So today we're looking at ways to deal with stonewalling so that you can come to a solution and problem solve. With this magic phrase, you are going to be a tactful and savvy and strategic communicator. Are you ready for the phrase? Here it is. If you can't communicate the problem, how can I help you? Or if you'd rather make it a declarative instead of a question at the end, you can say, if you can't communicate the problem, I won't be able to help you, right? So it's really important, and you can choose either variation on the theme, but this is the magic phrase. And as I always say, try it out yourself, make it a part of your communication toolkit, and then make it your own so that you can use it in the real world, because that is why we're here. So it's really important that your tone of voice is firm, but kind. You need to show that you're caring and that you want to be collaborative and you want to problem solve, but you're also not condoning that behavior where somebody is just shutting down and frankly doesn't feel like speaking. Well, a good communicator is really trying to make the effort to express themselves, right? So you be that good communicator and you can deal with the stonewalling that's happening. Now, this phrase is so powerful because it disarms the person who is stonewalling you. Suddenly they feel at ease, more at ease, at least, depending on the degree of frustration they're exhibiting and experiencing. But it really shows the person and signals to them, to the stonewaller, that you're there to help them. You're there to problem solve and that you have their best interests at heart. If you didn't, then you frankly wouldn't care, right? You leave them to their own devices and let them stay in a rut. But that is not who we are, and that is not what you're doing. The purpose here is to have them open up to you. And that is what this magic phrase does. So it disarms the person and it shows them that you care and that you are there to help them. Let's see this phrase in action. I want you to imagine a couple, Suzanne and Fred, and they are in a disagreement over the division of labor at home. So Suzanne is stonewalling Fred. She's giving Fred the silent treatment because she is not very happy about her current situation. She's juggling children, a husband, a household. And on top of all that, her boss is giving her a hard time with new deadlines for upcoming projects. Long story short, she has a lot on her plate. So she's feeling overwhelmed, but she's not articulating that to Fred. Instead, she's stonewalling him. So Fred, the savvy X-Learner communicator he is, decides to pull out that phrase, that magic phrase I just has taught you and try it on Suze. So he says, Suze, if you can't communicate the problem, I can't help you. So by saying this, Suzanne is disarmed and she's able to verbalize her frustration as to the huge workload that she feels like she's struggling with right now. And they are able to come to a solution because they talk it through. So you see, Xlearners, it's a matter of being able to break down that stone wall so that you're able to articulate your frustrations if you're the person giving the other communicator the silent treatment. If you're the stonewaller yourself, you know that you really should be expressing your frustrations so that the person that is trying to engage with you can help. And at the end of the day, you'll come to a great solution so that you can have a win-win or see eye to eye or just decrease your stress. Remember, Xlearners, most problems can be solved through strategic communication. When you communicate with confidence, authenticity, and poise, you're able to get your message across. And in this case, what we looked at today with stonewalling, you're able to break down the stone wall so that you can figure out what's ailing the person, get to the bottom of it, and find a solution together. So remember to use the marvelous phrase, what's the phrase again? If you can't communicate the problem, how can I help you? If you can't communicate the problem, I won't be able to help you. Add this phrase to your communication toolkit, make it your own, and try it out, see how it goes for you, and leave a comment in the comments below. If you enjoyed this lesson, which I hope you did, be sure to like, comment, and share. It really helps support the Xlearning community and all the work we put into this channel. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to join our tribe of Xlearners. And in my next lesson, I will be talking about how to best respond to the question, how are you? And it's not fine, thanks, how are you? I will see you in the next video. Happy Xlearning!